Welcome to Sesame Street. You're just in time, because I was just about to start fluffing my feathers. It's something we birds do to keep our feathers all soft and fluffy and feathery.
Oh, hi, Big Bird!
Hi, Elmo.
Oh, hi, everybody. Boy, Elmo loves it when Big Bird fluffs his feathers.
Really?
If Elmo had feathers, Elmo would do it too.
Oh. Well, why don't you do it anyway? And you can too, okay? Let's go. That's enough. How do I look?
Feathery.
Yeah. I feel nice and feathery, too.
Well, Elmo feels furry. Elmo wonders what it would feel like to be feathery.
Oh. Gee, Elmo, I guess you'd have to have feathers to really know.
Yeah, Elmo would have to be a bird. Oh, yeah. Elmo would love to be a bird and feel feathery all over. Elmo wishes he was a bird.
I'm here. Where am I? You're on Sesame Street, but who are you?
Well, take a look. The wings, the wand, the whole gestalt. I'm this little red monster's fairy god person.
Wow! Elmo didn't know he had a fairy god person.
Well, why are you here?
Why do you think? My cellular wand records everything. Listen.
Elmo wishes he was a bird.
Uh-huh.
Elmo wishes he was a bird.
Okay, we heard you.
Elmo
Okay, you can stop now. There you have it. I am here to grant your wish.
Oh, yay! Elmo's going to be a bird! Mm-hmm. Yay!
Mm-hmm. No, wait. You're going to turn Elmo into a bird?
And what's so hard about this? He wished to be a bird. I'm his fairy god person. Ergo, I will turn him into a bird. Stand back. I'm going to be waving a wand here. It's showtime.
A feathery bird is what you'll be.
Yes!
I'm giving you wish 123C. With feathers and beak and little bird feet. And wings you can flap when you chirp and you tweet.
Chirp, 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 chirp. Tweet, 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 tweet. Chirp, 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 chirp.
You did it!
Of course I did it! It's what I do.
Chirp, chirp, chirp.
Oh, excuse me.
Chirp, chirp.
Hello?
Tweet.
Okay, I'll be right there. I have to go now. There's a moose in Minnesota that wants to fly like a squirrel.
Chirp, chirp, chirp.
A flying moose. I'm gonna need the big wand. Ciao.
Elmo, you really are a bird. Now you got real feathers to fluff. Yeah. And you got a great beak for pecking, too. Oh, no. Hey, look at these great wings you got for flapping. Oh, and you can fly, too, like a bird.
Yeah, you are a bird.
But even I can't do that. Wow. Look at you, Elmo. You're a fluffy, feathery, flying bird. Hey, Alan.
Hey, Big Bird. Hey, you want a birdseed milkshake?
No, I think I'll have two today, Alan.
Oh, boy, you're really hungry, huh?
Well, no, one is for me, and the other is for Elmo. He's a bird today, Alan.
Oh, Elmo's pretending to be a bird? Well, you and Elmo have great imaginations.
Well, thank you, but we're not pretending, Alan. Elmo really is a bird.
Uh-huh.
Chirp, chirp, tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp.
You look kind of surprised, Alan.
Of course I'm surprised.
Yeah, well, Elmo says he'd like a chocolate birdseed milkshake, Alan.
But how?
Well, you know, how do you think? He wished it. His fairy god person came. He waved his big wand and, you know.
But Elmo's a monster. His mommy might not be ready for this.
Yeah, well, Elmo's happy. Alan, gotta fly. Time for the bird kateer meeting.
Chirp, chirp, tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp.
Oh, Elmo, sure, you can come. You'll be our guest bird.
Chirp, chirp, tweet, tweet.
Oh, it's gonna be at my nest. Well, this is gonna be a great meeting, Alan. Bye-bye.
Elmo's a bird.
Okay, Birdgeteers. Today we have a special guest. Now, let's give a big Birdgeteer welcome to Elmo Bird.
Hi, Elmo.
Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp.
Elmo loves flying now that he's a bird.
Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp.
I've got a great idea for this meeting. Birdgeteers, let's count how many times Elmo Bird flies by. Okay, Elmo?
Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp.
Oh, he likes the idea.
Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp.
Okay, and you can count with us if you want. Is everybody ready?
Yeah!
Okay. All right. Come on, Elmo.
Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp. Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp.
There's one. Okay.
Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp. Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp.
That's
two. Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp. Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp.
Three.
Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp. Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp. Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp. Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp.
Oh, you're going off behind. Watch out, Elmo. Hey, Super Grover.
Oh, what happened? I was minding my own business, being a superhero, when this birthday flew into my path, causing what we call in superhero jargon a crash. You okay, little birdie?
Chirp, chirp, tweet, tweet.
Oh, good, birdie. Listen, there is plenty of sky for both of us. Okay, well, so long, everybody. Gosh, that bird looks familiar.
Chirp, chirp.
Bye, Super Grover.
Tweet, tweet, chirp, chirp.
Well, I guess the meeting is over, Birdgeteers. So fly home safely.
Bye.
Bye. Say bye to Elmo.
Chirp, chirp, tweet, tweet.
Bye-bye.
Chirp, chirp, tweet, tweet.
Wow, Elmo, this is wonderful. Now that we're both birds, we can do lots of birdie things together. We can take bird baths, fluff our feathers, take birdie naps, eat bird seed, because now... you are a bird forever.
Chirp, chirp, tweet, tweet.
Oh, gee, bird forever. Gee, that means maybe I'll never see my little furry monster friend again, or hear his little furry monster voice.
Chirp, chirp,
gee.
Tweet, tweet.
Well, it's not the same, Elmo. Oh.
Chirp, chirp, tweet, tweet.
Yeah, well. Do you want to change back to your old furry self?
Chirp!
Okay, well, all right.
Chirp, chirp, tweet, tweet! Chirp,
not
chirp,
what?
Tweet, tweet! Chirp, chirp,
hey,
tweet,
how did you get him here before,
chirp,
Elmo?
Chirp, chirp, tweet, chirp, chirp!
Oh, right. You made a wish.
Chirp!
Great idea. Wish that you were a monster again, okay?
Chirp, chirp, tweet, tweet, chirp!
Oh. Hey, this better be good. I was surfing the net.
Chirp!
What?
Chirp, chirp, tweet!
You wish to be a monster again?
Chirp!
Oh, it's impossible to find a satisfied customer. Maybe I should just go back to dental school.
Chirp, chirp, tweet, tweet, chirp!
Okay, okay, stand back. It's showtime.
It's time to say the magic wordy. Hello, monster, bye-bye, birdie.
Chirp, chirp! Chirp, chirp!
You can talk, you know.
You're right! I'm as happy to be a monster again, yay!
Yeah, and I'm happy you're a monster again, too.
Okay, so you're happy, and he's happy. You sure you're all happy?
Oh,
yes!
Yeah, we're happy.
Good, then I'm happy, too. Oh, excuse me. Hello? What's that? Oh, I can do that. I can do that. No problem.
Huh. Was that somebody else with a wish?
No, it was my mommy. She wants me to bring home a loaf of bread and her prescriptions. Hey, I'm not just a fairy god person. I have a life, too.
Bye.
Oh, Big Bird! Let's go get another birdseed milkshake! Boy, I'm gonna like that! Chirp, 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 chirp!
Birdseed milkshake?
Big Bird, come on!
Oh, okay.
I wrote a poem called the hawk. The hawk flies, flies, and swoops down. His claws pick up a fish to eat. Black feathers, brown feathers, long wings spread to fly away south.
All right, Chrissy, you better get it right now.
Sure, cuz that looked like letter X. Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that smell like letter X. Yep. That tastes like letter X. Bye bye. Ha. Oh no. Oh, me ate letter X cookie. Oh, me feel tremendous guilt. Oh, now me can't show you letter X words. Oh, what?
Now just relax.
What's going on? Oh, X. X-ray. Ha ha. Excuse me.
This is the letter X.
It's time once again for the show that really babbles, starring that great babbler herself, the star of Baby Talk, Natasha, with the All Baby Band. And here's Natasha.
Baby,
And now it's time for Natasha's first guest, the star of the X-Files, the letter X.
Thank you, thank you.
Well, I need to do with the double D.
Oh, and I'm very excited to be here, Natasha. what spot is that? Oh, yeah. X does mark the spot. That's right, Natasha. Xylophone does start with the letter X. Oh, sure, Natasha. I'd be happy to show you my little trick. Watch this. See? Even upside down, I still look like the letter X. Either way, I'm the letter X.
And now it's time for Natasha's bottle. Uh-oh, it's time for the band's bottle, too.
You're excused.
With us tomorrow when Natasha talks to Madonna, Clint Eastwood, and her thumbs.
A sip of Novi device.
Perro.
Perro?
Perro.
Nice perro.
My dog is a big dog, quite big as you can see. But what if she were bigger? Bigger than a tree. What if she was the biggest dog yet? The biggest that a dog could get. But my dog is the best dog because she's my pet.
Oh, hello there. I'm just about to have some cereal. Birdseed Krispies, my favorite.
It's time to play Journey to Ernie, where Ernie hides and Big Bird seeks.
Oh, boy, that's my favorite game.
I know it is.
I wonder where Ernie's going to hide today.
Hey, you got chocolate milk? You'll never find me this time, Big Bird. Get along, little ducky.
Hurry, we've got to find Ernie. Count to 10, and remember, no peeking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ready or not, here we come. Uh-oh. I have a feeling we're not on Sesame Street anymore. Where are we?
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O.
Oh, wow. This is old MacDonald's farm, isn't it?
Aye, big laddie, that is. And I'm old MacDonald.
Have you seen my friend Ernie, old MacDonald?
Is he a sheep or a goat?
He's a person.
Then I haven't seen him, big laddie. Maybe you should ask the animals.
They don't miss a thing.
And asking questions is a good way to find things out. Well, good luck, big laddie.
Thanks, old MacDonald.
Yay, yay,
oh. Oh, I'll ask that horse. Whoa. Whoops. A haystack. I didn't see that there. excuse me, horse. I have a question. Have you seen my friend Ernie? Oh, dear. How can I ask the horse? I don't speak horse. I know. Horse, if you have seen Ernie, stomp your hoof once for yes and twice for no. That means yes. Is Ernie hiding that way? No. Is Ernie hiding that way? Yes. Thanks, horse. Oh, that's funny. That haystack wasn't there a minute ago. Ernie! Ernie! Come out wherever you are! Ernie!
Boom!
You got me. Have you seen Ernie?
Oh, moo moo here, quack quack there.
Moo moo here, quack quack there.
E-I-E-I-O.
Oh, that was good. Oh, I can ask that chicken. I speak chicken.
Chicken! Cluck cluck here, cluck cluck there. E-I-E-I-O.
Excuse me, chicken. Have you seen Ernie? Ask the pig. Asking questions is a good way to find things out? Okay. Excuse me, pig. Have you seen Ernie? Not again. Now I'll never find Ernie. I don't speak pig.
Oh, pardon me. Where are my manners? What I was trying to say is, Ernie's right behind you.
Behind me? Ernie! 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 Oh, I still can't see him. This haystack keeps getting in my way. It's like looking for an Ernie in a haystack. Wait a minute. It is like looking for an Ernie in a haystack. I'd know Ernie's lap anywhere. Ernie, are you in there? Aha! There you are!
You found me!
It's Ernie.
It's me.
I'd know you anywhere. The when you laugh, that Ernie shirt and hair. The squeaking of your ducky tells us you're the one. We found him, we found him. La 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 la. Our journey to Ernie is done.
Wait, you see where I hide next time. You okay, Bert? What's wrong? You look so sad.
Hi, Ernie.
Yeah?
You know Bernice, my pigeon friend. Mm-hmm. She was going to drop by, but then she had to fly off to visit her sick Aunt Matilda in Brooklyn. I had so many fun things planned.
Yeah? Well, cheer up, old buddy Bert. Maybe I can help, huh?
You?
Sure.
How?
Well, let me see. I could pretend to be Bernice.
Pretend you're Bernice? Ernie, that's ridiculous.
No, it's not, Bert. Look, I bet I could be as good a pigeon as anybody. You just tell me, Bert, what does Bernice usually do when she comes over,
Well, she coos.
Coos?
Yeah, you know, coo, coo, coo.
Oh, I can do that, Bert. Coo, coo, coo.
Not bad, Ernie. Mm-hmm.
Oh, please, call me Bernice. Now, what else does Bernice do, Bert?
Ernie, this is silly.
No, it isn't, Bert. Come on, tell me. Tell me, Bert. Come on.
All right. Yeah? Well, I always have some breadcrumbs for her, and she, pecks at them.
Aha. Uh-huh. So she pecks and coos. Watch this, Bert.
Huh?
Coo, coo. Peck, 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 peck.
Huh?
Coo, coo. Peck, 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 peck. Boy, this is really something, all right.
Oh, and that's just what we do for starters. Then comes the really exciting part.
Oh, yeah? What's that, Bert?
The hoop hopping.
The hoop hopping?
Yeah, the hoop hopping. Yeah, come over here. Let me show you this.
Okay. Yeah?
Yeah. You see this hoop?
Right.
Yeah. I've been teaching Bernice how to hop through it.
Really?
Yeah. Well, she hasn't quite gotten it yet, but she keeps getting closer.
Oh, you mean like this, Bert?
Coo, coo, coo.
Yeah, that's exactly what she does. She gets right up to the hoop and stops. I keep telling her, go, Bernice, go. You can do it. I know you can.
And hop.
That's it. You did it, Bernice. You did it. Oh, wow, you did it again. See, I told you could do it. I knew you had it in you, Bernice.
Bert,
didn't I keep telling
Bert,
you?
Bert, I think this is probably about enough pretend pigeon for one day, Bert.
Oh. Sure, Ernie, I understand. But boy, what a great pretend pigeon you make. You know, that really cheered me up, Ernie. Mm-hmm. You're a real friend.
Yeah.
I just hope I can do the same for you sometime.
Well, as a matter of fact, old buddy Bert, I just left Rubber Ducky at a play date with Radar and Big Bird, and, well, I'm kind of starting to miss him already. You know, his cute little duckiness and his little squeak, squeak, squeaky, you know? You wouldn't by chance want to do a little squeaking for me, would you, Bert?
Squeaking?
Oh, yeah. I guess that's something only a real friend would do for another one. Yeah, isn't it? Yeah.
Huh. Squeak, squeak.
Bert, that's wonderful. Hey, Bert, how about just a little waddle? Could you just do a little waddling for me, Bert?
Waddling
just a little waddle,
now?
Waddle, 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 waddle. Yeah, just a little waddle.
Waddle, 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 waddle.
That's
there.
Wonderful,
is that
Bert.
Okay? There, are you satisfied
listen, Bert,
now?
Bert, could you just do a little squeak, squeak along with the waddle, waddle? You know, put the two together like squeak, squeak, waddle,
this.
Waddle. Come on, Bert, just a little squeak, squeak, waddle, waddle.
Squeak, squeak. Squeak, squeak, waddle, waddle.
Oh, hey, Bert, anybody ever tell you that you'd make a great rubber ducky?
What?
Oh, can't you see? There's a bird on me. Oh, can't you see? There's a bird on me. I can't tell if there's one or two or ten or three. Don't want to complain or raise a fuss, but them birds up there think I'm a motor bus. Oh, gee, there's a bird on me. Oh, don't you see? There's a bird on me. They sit there talking to each other, not to me. Now, how do I find a way to explain that I'm not a boat or a railway train? Little birdie, fly away. Don't you come back no other day. Shoot. Oh, can't you see? There's a bird on me. Oh, woe is me. There's a bird on me. I'm so darn sick of every feathered friend. Oh, gee. Stop that chirping and quack, quack, quack. Come on, bird. Get over my back.
It is me. Did I fool you? Perchance, did you think I was a sheep? Did I pull the wool over your eyes? Well, it was certainly over my eyes. Now, I am on my way west to the desert in Arizona, which is way out west, where they call the wind Mariah for some reason. I do not know why. I am going so I can experience what it is like to be a sheep there. I know that is kind of nutty, but I got nothing else to do. But before I go, a little research. Let us watch this.
Here in Arizona, most of the water dries up in the summer. We have to take the herd down into the canyon where there's water to drink and grass for them to eat. A canyon is a deep valley. There's a trail down to the bottom. Some of the older sheep and goats know their way. The rest follow them. We stay behind with grandmother to make sure none of them get lost. Been cut out of the rocks. It will take all day to walk to the water. Along the way, we pass the houses where people used to live a long time ago. They carved pictures in the rocks. A canyon is a beautiful place. We have come a long way from the top of the canyon. Grandmother found a tree where we can rest. It's shady and cool. While we were resting, the sheep and goats went into the bushes to eat. We have to get them back on the path. When we cross the stream, we know we're close to the place where Grandmother keeps her sheep and goats in the summer. Just as the sun is going down, we get to our cabin. The sheep and goats will be happy here. There's grass for them to eat and a stream where they can drink. We will stay here all summer and help Grandmother take care of her sheep and goats.
That was very enlightening. Now I feel fully prepared for my trip to the desert. Wait, I am not the sheep! I am a monster! Stop the blind! Arizona's that way.
Madlenka, Madlenka lives in the universe. Madlenka, Madlenka lives right here on the earth with all her friends and neighbors who come from far and near. Madlenka, Madlenka, where are you?
I'm here. Today is the Super Intergalactic World Cup greatest soccer game ever with the best soccer player ever, me. I can see it now.
She's out the door. Around the corner. Blocked by a crafty defender.
Allez, Madlenka.
Got past him. Still in possession. A dogged opponent. That's using her head.
Vamos.
Nimble footwork. Stiff defense. She has an opening. She shoots.
Ready to play, Madlenka? Let the games begin!
It's bedtime once again! How wonderful! I get to count sheep and learn the number of the day! And if you would like to guess the number of the day, just watch for the elephant. Ready to go, my little tap-shoed sheep? Hit it. That's one tap-dancing sheep. That's two tap-dancing sheep. No, wait, that is a tap-dancing elephant in sheep's clothing. Yes. Almost pulled the wool over my eyes. And you know what that means, yes. Two is the number of the day.
Hey, hey, it's the number of the day. Two. Hey, 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 it's the number of the day.
What a terrific way to shuffle off to Slumberland.
Two.
Two dogs moving closer together. changing sides. The duet, 4-2.
Up and down like that.
You have to sit on the end of the seesaw.
The end of the seesaw. Mr. Noodle?
Uh-oh, he went down.
But he can't go up.
You need someone to sit on the other end.
Yeah, on the other end. Yeah. Mr. Noodle?
You can't seesaw alone.
Seesaws need two people.
You need two.
You need a partner.
Or a friend.
Then you can go up and down.
What you looking for?
What's that, Mr. Noodle?
What you got?
It's an ant.
Mr. Noodle, you can't go on with an ant.
Uh-oh. Bye-bye, ant.
I'm okay.
See? Mr. Noodle, you need something bigger to seesaw with you.
You need someone your size.
Yeah, try again.
Mr. Noodle, you need a bigger friend.
Think big. Think big. Think big.
Think big, Mr. Noodle.
Oh, Mr. Noodle has an idea. What are you doing, Mr. Noodle?
Mr. Noodle, that's too big.
He's big. Too big.
Mr. Noodle, you need someone your size.
He's too big.
He's gonna break the seesaw.
How can you
Okay, Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you go up and down on a seesaw?
Watch, Dorothy. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down.
Oh, thank you, everybody. Oh, and thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Mm-hmm. Oh, hello, baby. Hello. Baby, how do you go up and down? Oh, thank you, baby. That baby was gorgeous. Well, now, Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many times can a hippo go up and down on a pogo stick? Let's count them and see. Oh, there you are, hippo. Go ahead.
One, two, three, four, five.
To show you up and down, because when we superheroes fly, we go up and then we come back down. So up I go first into the sky. Here we go. Up. That was down, but that was not up. My cute little cape seems to be caught on something unseen and below the frame. Just a moment. Come on, Cape! Where was I? Oh, yes, I was on my way up. This time I will take a running start. How about that? Yes, this ought to do it. Okay, clear the runway! Up, up, and away! Not quitting is very hard on my little super body. I think I will be going down for the count now, Elmo. See you later.
Super Bob is very good at down. Oh, thanks, computer. Thanks. Elmo's friend, Diasia, goes up and down a lot at the playground, and she told Elmo all about it.
When I go to the playground, the first thing I do is run to the slide. I climb up the ladder and slide down the slide. Then I climb up again and slide down. Sometimes my friend Cindy and I slide together. We go up together and we slide down together. Up. Down. After the slide, I usually go to the swings. My mom gives me a push to get me started. Then I pump with my legs until I'm swinging way up high. I swing up and down. Up, down. It feels like I'm flying. I like to slide down the pole, but first I have to climb up. Then I slide down. Whee! Sometimes I go to the sandbox to play. I don't go up and down, but my toy airplane does. Up and down. Up, down. Then my daddy turns me upside down. It's kind of up and down at the same time. I love going to the playground.
Aw, thanks, Daisha. Boy, that's a lot of up and down. But Elmo wants to learn even more about up and down, don't you? How can we learn even more? We can watch the Up and Down channel. Oh. TV up. TV down. Very good, TV. 27.
Welcome to the Up and Down channel,
where things are always looking up and down. And now here's the Up and Down lady.
I love stairs because I love going up and down. You can go upstairs and downstairs and up again and down again. Ha ha! That reminds me of a dance. Who's up for a dance? All right then, everybody up and let's get down. Now this dance is going around. The up and down. So take your hands and lift them high. Bring them down, then up as if you're learning to fly. Let me hear you say up, up. Let me hear you say down, down. It's the best dance in town. So come and do the up and down. Let me hear you say
down. Oh, no, Judy. Thanks, TV. Boy, Elmo just loves that up and down dance, but Elmo still wants to learn more about up and down. How can we learn more? Oh. Hey, what's up?
I am. Oh. Now I'm down. Now I'm up again.
You're a yo-yo.
Well, thank you very much.
Wow. Well, what's it like being a yo-yo?
It has its ups and downs. Oh, you see this string here?
Yeah, Elmo sees the string.
Well, I can go up the string. Uh-huh. And I can go down the string.
Cool.
Up and down.
Wow. Yo-yos are very good at going up and down.
Oh, well, thank you very much. But there are a lot of other things that are good at going up and down, too. Huh? Like a roller coaster.
Yeah, a roller coaster. Yeah. Oh, hey, look, look, look. Hmm? Dorothy's imagining Elmo on a roller coaster.
May I sing along?
Sure, and you can sing too if you want. Up and down, up and down, up and down. Up and down, up and down, up and down. Up and down, up and down, up and down. Say goodbye, Dorothy. Say goodbye, Yo-Yo.
Goodbye, Yo-Yo. Doo-doo-doo.
I know. It's time for your bedtime story, Slimy. Now, let's see. The Adventures of Trash Gordon, Chapter 538.
The last time we saw our hero, Trash Gordon, he was on the planet Honk, where he was surrounded by a horde of honking honkers. They were horning in on our hero, but Trash knew exactly how to handle honking honkers. In the blink of an eye, he whipped out a dinger and his rubber ducky. And they all had a honker ducky dinger jamboree. Our hero was safe once again. As Trash slapped his thigh heroically to the beat, he said,
Sesame Street is brought to you today by the letter X and by the number 2.
Uh-uh.